The fire appeared to have started in Island Wear Shoe Store in the bottom section of the building near the corner of Brazil and Bridge Streets. The building is owned by former tourism minister Alan Chasney and his wife.
A fire started sometime last night, it seems, in the shoe shop, Island Footwear. You know, we're just waiting now for CID to come in. They've been able to contain the fire, and we're still waiting to assess the damage upstairs as well.
The owner of Island Wear Shoe Store says he was on his way to work Wednesday morning when one of his employees called to say that his business place was on fire. Mr. Aziz Hanif is one of three tenants occupying the building and appears to have been the worst affected by the blaze.
This is excessive damage because it's shoe, and shoe cannot stand up to the heat, right? And the smoke, the amount of smoke being coming out there. Right? And some of the shoes are the byproduct of gasoline. There's, you know, PVC, gasoline, right?
Three units from the St. Lucia Fire Service, including an ambulance, responded to the fire, and firefighters were soon able to bring it under control.
Upon the information that we received, that fire had been burning for a while. But it was confined within inside because there was no air coming inside, there was no oxygen so I could breathe. So it was more or less confined inside.
Firemen had to break into the building to get at the fire, but not before heat and smoke had done considerable damage not only to the shoe store, but to the law offices of Anthony Dubley and Company upstairs, and the Crave Cafe adjoining the shoe store.
Somebody called and they told me that my place burned down. So I kind of rushed from home and got here. But when I got here, I saw it was the shoe store because I was frantic, you know, that the business has just opened in November. And it was just, I don't know, it just had me all messed up.
Nevertheless, the Crave Cafe manager expects that once her rented premises are cleaned up, she will soon be back in business. The owners of the building, which was covered by insurance, anticipate that it will take more than a month to undo the damage caused by the fire. For the DBS News World, Melissa Paul reporting.